For a long time, for more than a decade, in fact, there was this period during which these concerns seemed fairly remote. Most people in the field, in the AI safety field, thought that we probably still have until the middle of the century or so before we really need to start worrying. It is now becoming increasingly clear that we will not have until the middle of the century. Possibly we will only have a few years left now. So one valuable thing as a programmer is that you understand when you understand and you understand when you don't understand. Because if I understand something in a way that I could describe to a computer and then it works after that, I know that I really understood it. Without really understanding what you're doing, you can put together a simple training regime where you get increased competence for just throwing more compute, more electrons, and more data at your system. And the system basically gets more and more competent as it just goes through more and more data using more and more compute. In some ways, it's not very unlike how humans developed by natural selection, because the evolution really didn't know what it was doing, so to speak. What it ended up with was organisms that are able to put rovers on moon. And we should be rethinking our posture towards potential dangers of AI. So we started with things like expert systems in the 80s. That was a big deal where people literally just talked to experts and then tried to figure out how experts make decisions and then just tried to program these concepts and recipes into machines. We got expert systems. So they were like super legible and super understandable. The big problem was that it didn't work very well. Then at some point we got deep learning. Then we had so-called supervised learning where you have humans give lots of examples of like, what does a cat look like? What does a dog look like? And then you basically train AI to figure out what is the difference between them. And then you had to worry about things like how clean is your data? Are you focusing on correct things? Are your labels, are the human instructions correct, etc., which kind of also helped you to kind of understand more about what your entire field is engaging in. And finally, now we have like this big black box, unsupervised regimes where you just grow AIs by throwing it lots of electrons and lots of data. AGI is, G stands for general, AGI is artificial general intelligence. What the general bit refers to is that you will have system that is not specific to any domain, such as face recognition or language translation. You have like this general decision-making and understanding machine that you can ask to solve problems in different domains. There is quite a bit of uncertainty in, because we don't know how human brains really work. It's possible that we are in for some surprises still, but given how quickly AIs are replicating our capabilities, it's possible that there isn't a lot of magic left in human brains. One mysterious thing about consciousness is that like it's not really obvious why do you need it. If you want to like win a chess game or do something in the world, which is what I would define intelligence being, it's not obvious like why do you need consciousness in order to achieve goals in the world. Indeed, I expect if we would be killed by AIs, I currently expect them to be not conscious. In some ways, that kind of like highlights the problem. We are about to, via reckless actions, extinguish the consciousness in this universe. And a really important fact about the current paradigm of AI is that people are developing those AI, they really do not know what they're doing. They're just growing those AIs, they're not building them. So like if there was like a significant suspicion that we might be creating machines that are able to suffer, like we should be just as careful as we are with animals now, when we kind of have suspicion that we might make them suffer. We shouldn't just do that. My definition of AI alignment is building AIs that would be motivated to build a future or bring forth a future that we would want if we were smarter and if we knew what the smarter AI knew. You can divide AI alignment into kind of two big sub-problems. These are basically known as outer alignment and inner alignment. Outer alignment is about knowing what kind of future we should build towards. And inner alignment is ability to steer AIs towards a given goal. And importantly, we as humanity are currently failing at both. We do not know what is a good future. And even more importantly, we have like no idea how to control AIs. I think it's like important to stress, like there's even a bit of a misnomer that people are doing, including myself, when we call the top AI companies as AI labs, because labs have this connotation of scientists. Like this is not science. Like AI, like the top AI paradigm is not about science. It's about just engineering. You have like business and almost ideological incentives. There is this tragedy of common situation where the thing that you're incentivized to do that gives you the most profit, the most investment, implies taking risks with the rest of humanity. Currently, AI companies do not really know what they're doing when they're poking at this thing that might blow up the universe. There is this concept called orthogonality thesis, which basically says that knowing and caring is not the same thing. The reason why humans have driven many species extinct is not necessarily because we are kind of evil. It's just because we don't care. We haven't cared about preserving the environment, for example, that the need to continue living. If we know that messing with the environment of other species will make them go extinct, that does not immediately imply that we care and we're going to stop doing it. Of course, we care a little, but like if there's something that we care more about, then it's bad news for the other species. It's very plausible that we will get a similar situation if we will fail to align AIs towards things that we think are valuable. So we will get AIs that do not care, and they will not care about life, they will not care about humans, they will not care about the environment, they will not care about the planet. They might care about the sun, because sun contains a lot of hydrogen, which is useful as a raw material and as energy source. So you can imagine, like if you have this super intelligent AI in the loose in the solar system and beyond, that only cares about the hydrogen in the sun and nothing else, it's very plausible that all life will disappear. The problem with very smart AI is not that it does not know what humans would want. The problem is that we don't know how to make it care. People have tried for like more than a decade now to figure out technically how do you steer AI that could potentially be smarter than you, and they have failed. Like it's unsolved technical problem. So sometimes I hear people saying that like we shouldn't restrict the training or growing of AIs at all. Like we really should be worried about the use and the deployment. But I think these people are making like a big mistake. For example, myself, I used ChatGPT to help me to configure my firewall at home. When you assume that deployment is something that only humans can do, you're really forgetting that deployment is about sending commands to computers in data centers. And AI knows how data centers work. They know how firewalls work. They know what AI deployment is, what AI training is. Of course, I'm worried that we might just inadvertently have AIs deploy themselves. When open source advocates say that like we shouldn't trust the big AI companies which has powerful technology, I think this is like very reasonable. But like one thing open source as an answer implies is that you should then trust the worst possible actor. These actors will be much worse than the centralized top AI companies currently. One important concept in this discourse about AI risks is the concept of burden of proof. Who should have the burden of proving that this is safe, or vice versa? My position is that burden should be on the companies to prove that what they are developing and what they are training and what they are releasing is safe to do. Why this is safe? Why this is not risking everyone else's lives, because I do think that currently they are. The silver lining is that this is something that will affect everyone. So as long as we kind of make it more clear and obvious to people that this is like a thing that kind of where we live or die together, I think this might actually create an opportunity for global regulation. One very reasonable place to start with is like figuring out what kind of computational limits we should set on the AI growing experiments. If it is true, as I believe, that AI companies who are growing those huge AIs, they really don't know what's happening under the hood. There should be like limits on like how big their load to train that way. I generally kind of hesitate when it comes to kind of describing best case scenarios, because like they are almost certainly going to be wrong in detail. But I do think that there are like some properties that I think are good scenarios. I would very much like to explore ways how we could use AI and potentially other technologies to make humans and human groups, human organizations smarter in a way that doesn't kind of make them deviate from human values and ethics. Something where we would be able to enhance human thinking and human communities in a way that makes us more reflective and less impulsive and therefore kind of more wise. The most likely worst case scenario, which isn't really worst case scenario, is like everyone just dies really quickly. And I think unfortunately currently it's the most likely scenario. I can imagine even worse scenarios where we wish we'd died, but we couldn't. But like, luckily I think these are very unlikely. I mean, I think it's possible to imagine like several points of no return. Things like when AI becomes just really good manipulator, better than any politician, better than any CEO or religious leader. That's like a sort of like fairly easy to understand point of no return. The main one that I'm concerned about is AI becoming better in AI development than humans are. And then like, if you have the situation where GPT-6 is going to be developed by GPT-5 on hardware that it invented and installed, it's pretty much game over for humans. So given what I currently know, I think we should just postpone this indefinitely. We should not build a godlike AI before we know what we're doing.